Welcome to this video on entity registration. In this video, we'll look at the entity information page and the entities widget in the SAM.gov workspace. We will also cover how to register a new entity, check existing entity information status, and how to renew or update an entity registration. Let's start on the Entity Information landing page. From the SAM.gov homepage, select the Entity Information link. This will take you to the Entity Information page. You must be signed in to search and view entity information in SAM.gov. If you are not already signed in, you'll need to do so now. Select the Sign In button and complete the sign-in process. After signing in, you'll return to the Entity Information page. Notice that the search feature is now accessible. For additional information on searching entity information, please see our Entity Registration Advanced Search video. Select the Workspace link in the top right corner of the SAM.gov homepage to access the Entity Workspace. Selecting the What Do I Need for Registration link will take you to the Get Started with Registration and the Unique Entity ID page. This page contains information on what you will need to get started with the registration. It also links to fsd.gov, where you can find answers to frequently asked questions about registration and other links to additional resources. Select any of the available links for more information on entities and registration, as well as saving searches for future use. Select the links in the Before You Get Started widget to view a roadmap of items to complete before registering an entity. Here you will find information on how to get a unique entity ID, how to set up a SAM.gov account, preparing the necessary data to register an entity, and how to start the entity registration process. There are three options within the Register Your Entity tile. Get started if you have not yet registered a new entity. Renew Entity if you have an existing entity that needs to be renewed or updated. Check Entity Status if you need to view the registration status of your given entity. The Get Started link will take you to the welcome screen to create a new entity. See our video on getting a unique entity ID for more detailed information on this process. Select Go to Workspace and then select the Entities link or the Renew Update link to register or update an existing entity. You can also pull up a specific entity or a list of entities from the Entities page by selecting from the Entity Status buttons at the top of the Workspace Entities widget. From the Entities page, select Register from the Actions button to begin the registration process. Answer the questions and enter all required information through the overview, Purpose of Registration, Core Data, Representations, Certifications, and Points of Contact. Once you enter all of your data, submit your registration. Select Back to Workspace to return to SAM.gov. To check your status, select the Checked Entity Status on the SAM.gov homepage. Here you can search for the status of an entity. Federal government users can use this tool to view the status of any entity. Use a unique entity ID or CAGE code to search for an entity status. If your entity is pending assignment of a unique entity ID, you can search by legal business name. Entity name and status are visible in the return search results. The More About section on this page contains clickable panels. Select each panel for information related to getting started with registrations and entity status guide, a registration status legend, failed TIN validation, failed CAGE validation, and additional help resources and user guides. Select the back arrow to return to the SAM.gov homepage. If you have already registered an entity, you may need to update that registration or renew it as required on an annual basis. To do so, select the Renew Entity link. This page is your entity workspace and displays each entity currently associated with your account. If multiple entities are shown, you can use the filters to find the entity that you want to update. If you know the name of the entity, enter a keyword search. You may also filter by unique entity ID, CAGE code, entity name, status, expiration date, FSD number, or whether the entity needs an address update or not. Once you locate the entity that you want to update, select the Actions button, the three vertical dots, then select Update to begin the update process. Make the updates that are required, and select Submit when complete. If you need to deactivate an entity registration, you can select the Actions button on the record and then select Deactivate. Select Yes in the drop-down menu to confirm deactivation. Then select Submit to complete the process. Once a registration has been deactivated, it cannot be reactivated. Deactivation deletes the registration data connected to the unique entity ID. The unique entity ID itself remains in SAM.gov as an ID assigned entity in case it needs to be re-registered in the future. Earlier, we explored the Entities widget in the SAM.gov workspace. You can also view entity information in active, pending, or submitted states. Select the individual icon to view your entity information in each state. Clicking the Entities link in the widget will pull up the Entity workspace. This page displays all entity information associated with your account. These records can be filtered, viewed, and managed as discussed previously. Select the back arrow to return to the workspace. For more information on entity registration, please visit the Entity Information link on the SAM.gov homepage. To provide feedback about features, functionalities, or about the user experience in SAM.gov, click the Feedback button located at the bottom of the site. Thank you for watching.